stuff today, some really simple basics, but hopefully it'll get your heart rate up and hopefully you'll be sore tomorrow for a few days, because if you're not, do it again, because you should be. Okay, so we're gonna start off with some really basic moves that you need to know just in general to get started in cardio kickboxing, and that is how to punch. Okay, so I'm gonna show you a 1-2 combo. We're gonna do our hooks, and we're gonna do our uppers, and then we're gonna do some other stuff around there. Okay, first off though, you need to know how to stand. I know that sounds silly, but you do. You have to know how to stand. As you can see, I am barefoot because I am on my jiu-jitsu mats in my garage. And in MMA, you're barefoot. So that's the whole thing. Sorry. My jacket fell with my phone. I'm not worried about it. That's the whole concept of doing this is you are balanced. You are, you know, you're able to move. You can go wherever you need to. You can switch stances, boom, wherever you're going, okay? So first things first, if you are right-handed, you need to stand with your left foot in front and your right foot behind, okay? So from a side view, if you are left-handed, you are the exact opposite. You have your right foot forward and your left foot back, okay? Because this is your power leg, all right? Your back foot is your power leg, and you are going to start out everything with your right hand. So your first punch will actually be with your right hand, okay? So simple, basic, right-handed people, left-handed people, okay? So I'm right-handed, therefore I'm going to stand with my left foot forward and my right foot back. All right, southpaws, lefties, you're gonna do everything I do except the opposite, but I'll still show you how to do it. All right, so it's a simple 1, 2, 3, 4 in stand-up, and it goes 1, 2, 3, 4, okay? So I have a jab, I have a straight, I have a hook, and I have an upper. All right, so first things first, we start with our jab. I want you guys to see how my arms are. I'm staying relaxed in the shoulders. All right, that's my biggest thing, is I'm always being told to relax because I also want to hunch up and protect myself. That's not the case. All right, I want to stay relaxed in the shoulders. When I do that, my left hand is going to be the one that I throw first, because that is my, like my Kickstarter one, okay? My right hand is my power, but my left is my starting punch, okay? So I want to go, when I throw my punch, I start out in front, okay? My hands are always protecting my face. I keep loose, I'm moving, I'm always on my toes, okay? When I throw, watch how I turn my hand. I turn my fist to where it's not like this, like how I had it when I was punched, or when I started, I turn it. The reason I turn it is because I don't want to break my fingers. I like my fingers, I need my fingers. All right, so I also don't want to punch down here or up here or just be lazy with it, because that's not how you do it and it's terrible form. All right, so when I throw my punch, I have my hands above my face and I just throw it straight, okay? Or sorry, I throw a jab, but this is my jab. So I go jab, jab, jab. Lefties, same concept, but with the right foot forward and starting out with your right hand. So I go jab, jab, jab. Notice too how my shoulder is protecting my chin. And every time I bring my hand back, I'm bringing it back to my chin. Boom, boom, all right? You have to bring that hand back to your chin because you have to protect your face. You don't want your hands down here. You don't want your hands like way up here. You want your hands to protect your face, okay? Boom, 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 boom. All right? So that was our 1-2. So we go 1, back to the face, 2. Notice too how I'm on my toes when I'm turning. 1-2. 1-2. 1-2. I'm protecting my face. I'm rolling my shoulders. They're staying low. I'm relaxed. And I'm turning my body with my punch. All right? From there, we have our hooks. Okay, I'm going to start at the face as well. I'm going to kind of crunch my body up on my toes. I go hook and I come back. Hook and I come back. Hook and I come back. Okay, this is the idea that you are trying to hit them in the jaw. Hook, body, be down here, hook, hook. All right, so I'm going for that hook. Notice too, my arm is straight. I have turned my wrist. I don't keep it blah. It's not loose. It's nice and strong. Hook, hook. And you're gonna do that on both sides, okay? Turn your body back. Turn your body back. Hook, 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 hook. All right, there's your hooks. Now we have our uppers, okay? So uppercuts, kind of the same concept. Always in your fight stance. Hands start at your face. I'm gonna come down a little bit. So I'm gonna do a little like side squat, kind of like an oblique, an oblique crunch. Here we go. So I go down, I come up, boom. I start out with my hand that is on the foot that's forward. So again, my righties, start out with your left. Lefties, start out with your right, all right? So I'll do a lefty example with this one. So same thing, crunch down, come up, boom. And I'm not doing this, I'm still turning my fist. I don't wanna break my fingers or my knuckles, so I have to do it like that, okay? So I crunch down and I come up, boom, and I retract, kind of like a praying mantis, okay? So I come down, boom, all right? You can see it come up on my toes right here because I'm pivoting my body, boom. Boom, 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 boom. Same concept, all right? That's how I'm comfortable. Boom, boom. And the idea of this is you're literally trying to punch their nose through to their skull, all right? So a little morbid, but just imagine that. Somebody's face is in front of you, you're protecting yourself, that's where you're aiming for, okay? Boom, 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 boom. All right, and I'm not looking for speed right now. I'm just looking for an understanding of it. All right, so we're just gonna do some basics. Let's just do 10 straights, 10 hooks, and then 10 uppers. All right, we're gonna do 3 sets of those in a row right now. So we just got our straights, we got our hooks, and we got our uppers. All right, so 10, 10, 10, 3 times, okay? If I do 10 sets of 3, that's 30. 3 times 3 is 90, so we're going to do 90 punches right now. All right, so get ready. Get your fight stance in 3, 2, 1, go. Last set. All right, so there's that. Really basic, your straights, your hooks, and your uppers. All right, so now we are going to do those in a combo, okay? So let's just work on some upper stuff today. We won't do some squats. Or maybe we will. I don't know, I haven't decided yet. Okay, so we have our jab, our straight, our hook, and our upper. What we're gonna do right now is called a jab, jab, cross. So 1-1-2, and then we are going to do a hook, hook, upper, upper, and then jab straight, hook, hook, upper, upper. Oh my God, that's so much. I know, it's okay. So again, we stay in our fight stance. We are going to do a 1-1-2, or a jab, jab, straight, jab, jab, cross, however you want to call it. Alright? So again, make sure your shoulders are nice and relaxed. Learn how to stand in your fight stance. Boom, right here, up on my toes. Make sure your feet are shoulder width apart and you are comfortable. Shoulders relaxed. You're breathing. Okay? Please breathe. I don't want anybody passing out, okay? Even though I'm not there. So we're just gonna do a 1-1-2 right now, all right? And we're gonna do, let's do 5 sets of those, but I wanna show you first. So it goes 1-1-2, okay? 1-1-2. And we'll go about that speed too. There's no reason to rush it. So this is your jab, jab, straight, okay? So we're gonna do, I think I said 5, so a total of 15 punches right here. All right, so ready, get your fight stance. We're gonna go in 3, 2, 1. Notice too, I'm always bringing my hands back to my face when I do this, all right? I'm still protecting my face. I'm turning my hands down, and I'm always pivoting and moving. Jab, jab, cross, hook, okay? So we're gonna combine that. We're gonna go jab, jab, cross, hook, hook. All right, so you're doing combos now. You guys are growing up so fast, right? So jab, jab, straight, hook, hook. Notice too how I start with my original hand after I complete that two. All right, it's not always going to be the case, but to keep it simple, we'll do that. All right, so here we go again. Hands up, goes jab, jab, straight, hook, hook. Jab, jab, straight, hook, hook. Turn your body. If you're just doing this, you're not going to feel it where you need to feel it. You have to get that hip movement in there. All right, relax those shoulders. Turn your body with it. Okay, so pivot. Take your shoes off. I don't even know. Do you have your shoes off? Do you have socks on? I don't know. Do you have shoes on? Is it helping? I don't know. It doesn't help me. So we're just going to do that again. All right? So again, one more time. Jab, jab, straight, hook, hook. Okay? So let's do 5 of those. Ready? In 3, 2, 1. One, jab, jab, straight, hook, hook, to remember if I say things out loud or if I'm counting in my head, do that. All right, so let's go ahead and let's do some abs. Yay, spirit fingers. Everybody likes abs. Just kidding. We have to. All right, so hopefully you guys can see me. The abs that we are going to do is we are going to do starfish, toes, bicycle crunches, planks, another set of regular crunches, and a plank rock, okay? So first thing we're gonna do is we are going to do starfish. So you need to be on your back. Make sure you guys can see me. Okay, so you're on your back, your arms are extended, your legs are out. What you're gonna do is you're going to take the opposite of both and you're gonna come up, that hand needs to sit down, you're gonna come up, touch your toes, come back down. 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 All right? So I need more than you right now. So we're just gonna do five on each side. Make sure you are breathing, okay? Make sure you are staying strong in your core. You're not just being lazy with it, okay? You really need to get that stretch. Try to bring your shoulders up off the mat if you can, or the carpet, wherever you're at. It's so loud where I live. All right, but we're gonna do five on each side. Okay, so here we go. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go. Last one. All right, now what did I say we're gonna do? We are going to do, oh, tummies. Yay, my favorite, just kidding. All right, my coach loves these. She loves to torture us. Okay, so tummies, legs are straight up in the air. If you need to put a little bend in them, that's fine. My legs are shaky. Because I worked out the other day, it's been too long. All right, so tummies, start at your toe, you go to your knees. Tummies, that's literally it. Okay, if you want to advance it for you fancy people, what you can do is you can do a toe, go down, bring it up, do it again. Go down, do not touch the ground, bring it up, do it again. Okay, so I will do five of each. So I'll do five regular toes so that you can see it, and then I'll do five of the advanced toes, or just the super extra toes. I'll start out with the advanced ones right now. Okay, so we're gonna do a total of 10. Let's see, 10, all right? Try to, again, bring your shoulder blades up off the mat. Don't just stay there if you can't. This is gonna work your core, your upper abdominals, and everything in between. It's also going to work your legs, believe it or not. Okay, especially if you do the extra one. The modified, if you can't do the legs at all, just do a regular crunch with the reach, okay? Try to get that reach in. Or you can even do it with one leg, okay? Boom, boom. Back, boom, boom. All right? Do it as much as you can. Okay, so we're gonna do 10 in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Regulars. Okay, so that wasn't too bad. Oh, I feel it though. All right, let's do a plank. All right, everybody knows what a plank is. Make sure you can do it a couple ways. So a regular plank, making sure that your back is flat. Okay. Never actually seen myself do a plank until now. So make sure your back is flat, your core is tight. If you need to modify it, you can put one knee down. But don't put it way up here, that doesn't make any sense. Just do a regular one, bring it directly down, or you can do two knees down, but you still need to make sure that your back is flat. Hold your partner accountable, okay? My arms are out, boom, to move my hips to the mat on each side, side to side, okay? So here is what it should look like. Hopefully I know that's totally up, okay? So regular plank, I'm just gonna drop and drop. Drop and drop, okay? Keep your elbows firm on the mat or the carpet. Keep your core nice and tight and you'll be good, okay? So let's do a 10-second plank and then we'll do 10 of the plank rock, okay? So I'm going to be facing this way. If you cannot do the plank rock, that's okay. Try just holding it for 10 to 15 more seconds because you'll feel it, all right? So let's do that. I'm going to do a regular plank for 10 seconds, and then at the end of those 10 seconds, I'm just going to do the plank rock, and hopefully I don't fall on my face, which I shouldn't. All right, so here we go. Remember, modified plank position, one knee down or two knees, but still back, and you can still rock, all right? So here we go in 3, 2, 1. Okay, for the rock. I feel that. Okay, that's so bad. All right, so let's end that off a little easy. Let's just do some really basic crunches. So everybody knows how to do a crunch. I'm sure Mr. Nunes would be very proud to see that you still know how to do a crunch. So we just go to our back. Okay. To really engage your core, try always keeping your head off the ground. It makes a huge difference in the way that you build muscle in the back, your shoulders, and even just holding up your core. Right? So if you're like this, obviously you're not engaged too much because you're literally being nothing. You're just laying here. It's like you're laying in bed. But if you have your head up, your head weighs like 10 pounds. That's a lot of pounds. Not everybody's head weighs 10 pounds. But still, even if you're a 6-pound head, that's a lot of weight being held up. Okay? So we're just gonna do a regular crunch. What you can do is you can have your hands out to your side, or if you wanna advance it a little bit, don't hold your head up. Just like touch behind your ears. So you can feel it, all right? We're just gonna do a really regular, basic crunch. So we're just gonna bring up, back, okay? Don't touch the head to the floor. Don't hold your head up using your hands. Just up and back. If you can touch your knees, awesome. If you can't, awesome. I don't care, it's fine. You're doing something, that's all that matters, okay? So feet off the ground, hands behind your ears, or in front of you, or on the side. You can reach, okay? But here we go. We're gonna do just 10. All right, ready? In 3, 2, 1, go. All right, so there's that. There is our core one. I think we can do this. Let's do squats because my legs haven't had enough torture in the past few days. Okay, so we are going to do squats, lunges, and just some basic bouncing around fight stance stuff, okay? So for regular squats, again, shoulders need to stay relaxed. Feet are about shoulder width apart. When you're coming down, you're not leaning forward. You're not bowing. Okay, you're literally pretending like you're sitting in a chair, okay? So all you're gonna do is you're just gonna go down and you're gonna come back up. Okay, try to make your knees not go past your toes. I do know a few things, okay? So from the side view, okay, my feet are shoulder width apart. I'm just dropping like I'm sitting in a chair and I'm coming up, all right? I'm just dropping my knees. I'm actually driving through my heels. I'm not coming up on my toes, okay? Which I move through my heels and back up. Okay, that is your basic squat. From there, we are going to do a lunge, and then we can just bring it up. Let's do a little bit of extra, because why not? So from here, we're in our lunging position, or our squatting position. We're gonna take a step back with the other leg. We're gonna go down, let's pulse for two, and bring it up. Down, pulse for two, and bring it up, all right? We're gonna do that on both sides. You'll feel that. And don't worry about being all fancy, just bring your knee up. Try to point your toe. Actually, don't point your toe. Keep your toe nice and engaged. You'll feel it in your shin eventually, and it'll feel great. You'll be like, I didn't know I have those muscles. And your body will be like, oh my God, where did these muscles come from? Okay, so let's do 10 squats, 10 lunges on both sides with the knee every two. So 5 knees in between, and then we'll do some bikes and stuff. Okay, so really basic squat. We're gonna do 10, ready, in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go. You guys can't hear it, but my knees are popping. Is that 8, I think? All right, now let's do our lunge, right? Pulse lunge for 2, bring it up for the knee. Okay, so we're gonna go back. Ready? In 3, 2, 1, let's go. Knee. Working. Last two. There we go. Other side. Ready. Lunge position. 3, 2, 1. Let's go. Last one. All right, good job. And now basic bike stance stuff. Let's just kind of cool our heart rate down. Let's keep our hands up and get your bike stance. We're just gonna bounce around a little bit. Okay, so you're on your toes. You're gonna feel it in your calves. Just move around. Let's do this for 10 seconds. Ready? 3, 2, 1, go. You guys want to throw some punches? Go ahead. All right. And I think that about does it. I think that was really good. If your guys' heart rate isn't up, then I don't know what you've been doing, but mine is. So we are going to do a big breath in. We're going to do a cool down. Guys, you have to make sure that you do a cool down, okay? So what we're gonna do is we're gonna inhale up and down. Okay, let your body hang. Don't worry, stretch out those legs. You're gonna go to your right side, grab your ankle, get the dog hair off of your pants like me. Remember to breathe, go to the other side. Remember to breathe. Back to the center. Roll it up nice and slow. Okay. Now, we're gonna do across the chest. So take one of your arms, cross your chest. Use the other arm to pull that direction. So pull your shoulder. Get a nice stretch in your shoulder. I can feel it. That's a good thing. All right. Now over the head. Pull on your elbow. Reach down. Try to touch the center of your back. other side. Pulling, stretching. There you go. Remember to breathe in your nose, out your mouth. Go behind. Again, pulling the elbow. Try to touch the center of your back. Try to touch right in between those shoulder blades. Okay, and the last one, really simple. Roll out the neck. Okay, just roll your head. Again, your head is really heavy, so it's important to roll it out. Either way, do 5 rolls that way. Okay, 5 rolls the other way. I think that was 5. I lost count. It feels good. All right. So if you guys need to roll anything else out, you need to roll out your shoulders, rolling back, rolling forward. Okay. Stretch back. You can do, call this the washing machine. Looks so fun, like an optical illusion with the sun. But yeah, so really good job. Now go drink some water. Go do your homework if you haven't done it. And I hope you guys have an awesome day. I hope you enjoyed this, and if you watched it, thank you. I hope you actually had fun with it, and thank you guys again for being so awesome during this crazy time. Know that I'm thinking of you every day. I miss you all, and I love you all, and I hope you're staying safe. And remember, I'm always here if you need anything. You have my number. You have my social media accounts. Hit me up any way, shape, or form, okay? I'm going to do another video on Thursday, but we're going to do some jujitsu stuff, so at least one of you will know how to do this stuff. Yeah. Okay. So that'll be fun. And we'll be done here in my garage again. Yay. See, I don't even have to leave the house. Ugh. Go me. All right. Peace out, guys. Love you all much. Talk to you later.